guys, thanks for watching. Today we're going to talk about something that gets really close to home for me and for a lot of you viewers. You've probably read or heard that you're short, you can't ride a sport bike or even a cruiser at that unless it's super low. I'm going to show you that that's not true, so stay tuned. Over here we have a 2006 R6. It's a very tall bike, very wide saddle. I'm 5'3" with a 29 to 30 inch inseam. The saddle on this thing is incredibly wide, so it's going to be difficult for you as a shorter person to ride something like this. It takes a lot of practice and a lot of skill because things are going to be awkward with this bike. For one, getting it up, getting the kickstand back. That's the worst part about riding this bike, is getting on and getting the kickstand up. Getting back off is easy. I just rotate my hips around, put a foot down, swing over, kick the stand, and let the bike rest. It's not a big deal. Getting up and getting my leg to reach over and kick it up, that's the hard part. So, once we mount the bike, leg over, right peg, well, now we have to get it up. I'm on the ball of my foot. You can see this bike is way, way taller. Is it manageable? Yeah. Once you start going, it's easy to ride this bike. But the big part for a short person is starting and stopping. So as we rotate the bike up, straighten the handlebars to help balance. A straight handlebar and wheel is a more balanced bike than being turned off to the side. If you watch some videos that talk about how people have dropped their bikes, notice that it's usually when they apply too much front brake and their front wheel is turned. That'll cause you to slide, lock up, it shifts the center of gravity and the weight of the bike, and the result is a person falls over and, oh my God, I dropped my bike video is all over the internet. So, on this bike, as I shift my hips so I can put my right leg down, you have to balance the bike. You have to learn how to balance these bikes. Now, as you'll see here, my leg is super, super, super short. There you go. I had to really go on my tiptoes on my right foot and stretch, but that's how I do it. Now, you're going to hear a lot of people say you need left foot down at stops, not your right foot. That's what the safety course teaches. Yeah, it is. Those safety courses and your state licensing exams have to assume you have zero riding skill, zero ability, and you're 100% nervous. That when you get out into traffic, you need to do things as safely as possible. And that's a good way to start. Left leg down, cover the right brake on the foot brake. Use your foot brake for slow speed and stopping mostly. But do not omit using your front brake. That is your stopping power. When you are coming from highway speeds to a slow to a stop, that front brake is going to stop you more than your rear. Newer bikes have ABS on them, so you don't have to worry about sliding your front as much. The Kawasaki over here, it has ABS on it, and when it engages, it'll kind of freak you out. It's a different feeling for me. It's the first bike I've had with ABS. This bike does not have ABS. It's just regular front brake, rear brake, and that's about it. But now, what do I do if I'm coming to a stop? It all depends on the situation. If it's sloped to the right, I will put my left leg down. Primarily, I always leave this bike in gear unless it's an extended stop. And then, I make sure traffic behind me has stopped. I watch this mirror. When traffic behind me has stopped and I feel comfortable enough that I can rest my clutch. This is a very stiff clutch. This is a racing clutch in this bike. This is something you don't want to sit for a minute or two at a stoplight and have to hold. You know, call me a pussy or whatever, but hop on here and try it yourself. You don't want to get stuck in traffic with this bike anyway, as a short person. It's just too aggravating, a lot of shift and balance. But yeah, generally, I am right leg down because it's easier, it's more comfortable for me. I guess. It's just over the years how I've developed my riding style. But yeah, you can do left leg down if you want to follow the safety courses and all that to the T. Hey, do what's comfortable for you. Do what you need to pass that test, and as you get experience and you ride, you'll learn your own style and what fits you. And that's perfectly normal. That's just the way it all works. So, if anybody jumps on you for saying that right leg down or left leg down or one of the way is not correct or whatever, they are probably someone that just took the course, they're not an experienced rider, or they're only repeating bullshit they've heard on the internet or other videos. Do what works for you. Do as the course instructs you to do. That is the absolute safest way. I'm 100% in agreement with that. Cover your brakes. There's going to be a lot of situations where covering that foot brake is not needed. It's not needed at all. Once I come to a stop, I don't put my feet down until my bike is almost completely still. Again, that goes back to balancing. If you feel like you're going to use an argument where, if you're going to use an argument of keeping the back brake covered as a preventative for being rear-ended or rolling backwards or anything of that nature, that is nothing to do with what leg you have on the ground. That is 100% your fault for not being situationally aware of what's going on around you. I keep my eyes on that rear view mirror, one eye down and one eye over, to make sure traffic behind me has stopped. I do not take the bike out of gear at any time until cars behind me have stopped. And then I still don't take it out of gear unless the light's taking a considerable amount of time. That's why I choose to keep my right leg down and my left leg on the shifter. But I do use both. I alternate. Watch my videos. You'll notice I sometimes shift to the right, sometimes I shift to the left, but my head is always moving, looking around, checking mirrors. Situational awareness is key to motorcycle safety. Especially as a short person, when you're having a hard time managing a bike like this, you have to be even more cautious. So, with that being said, I'm going to shift my weight with kickstand up, at a stop, balancing the bike, back to my left leg. Watch my hip rotation. I have the brake covered with one finger, my front brakes. That's to prevent me from rolling, shifting, moving, because you may have to do this at a stop on a slight incline, and you're not covering your brakes. There you go. Just one smooth, fluid motion, and now I'm covering the rear brake with my right foot. So, a super sport is a different bike than a regular sport. The position is different. This bike is super fun to ride for an hour or two, as long as I'm not going through stop-and-go traffic. And the biggest thing for that is my wrists start to hurt. I'm a shorter stature person. I really, really have to lean over to support my body weight. I'm 38. I feel it in my lower back from the general work that I do. Do a lot of maintenance on equipment. I'm always bent over working on things. And at the end of the day, I don't want to jump on this super sport because I'm tired. I just want to blow off some steam. I'll hop on that bad boy. But yeah, this gets a little uncomfortable as you're shorter. You're as not stretched out, so you can't rest as easily. So keep that in mind if you're looking for a sport bike. Go to the dealerships, sit on the bikes, get comfortable with everything that they have. So, as we rotate back over, step off the bike, support the weight, stand down, and there you are. Now, over here, it's the 2017 Kawasaki Z650. 30 and a half inch seat height, almost 31, I think. So a couple inches lower than the R6. Very comfy bike. I like it. I bought this bike specifically for the riding position, the comfort, and still have the sport bike feel. I got rid of a cruiser not long ago, just because I really didn't ride it that much anymore. But I kind of miss the comfort, you know, so that bike doesn't cut it. This bike does. A lot lower seat height. That's not the only important factor. How slim a saddle is. It's hugely, hugely advantageous to someone that's short. This bike is probably half the width of that as far as saddle. It's a little hard, a little stiff. It's brand new. I'm hoping it'll soften up a little bit. That's the only comfort downside I've found to this bike. Super lightweight, just over 400 pounds. Easy to manage. Again, push up, straighten the wheel, and not much hip rotation at all is needed. Upright position, it's very comfortable. I love this bike. And also, it's a lot easier to kick the stand up and down. So, there's one foot on the ground. I have my hips slightly shifted off to the right, not by much. Like I said, I have about a 30-inch inseam, so it's really close to the seat height. Even if you were shorter, this bike would be easy to manage. It's well balanced, but you know, look at my right leg, I'm down, I'm ready to crank, begin, put the bike in gear, and take off. Now coming to stops with this bike, I still pretty much use right foot down. It's just what's more comfortable to me. I guess maybe I feel like my body is stronger on the right side. Perhaps that's it. I don't know. I know what to do safely when I'm riding in traffic. I've been riding for 21 years on the street. But yeah, I usually cover the clutch, keep the bike in gear still with right foot down. Situational awareness, I'm always checking my mirrors. Again, watch some of my ride-along videos and you'll see. Situational awareness, that's more important than any foot you can put on the ground. Shift that weight around. This bike is super, super easy. I don't recommend it as a 100% beginner bike. If you have any kind of riding experience, whether you're coming from a smaller bike or a smaller cruiser, you want to step into a sport bike. If you have any off-road riding experience, why are you watching this video? Because dirt bikes are super tall and you should know what you're doing, right? The only difference is you're doing it on the street. Be safe, learn your traffic laws, and go to a dealership, sit on every make and model bike that they have, ask questions. Go to different dealerships and ask them questions about particular bike models. Take the general consensus of what you hear and you'll get a good idea of what the actual truth is rather than thinking maybe a dealer is trying to upsell you on a product. I went looking for a bike about a month ago, and I had a particular bike in mind. It was the Suzuki SV650. I grew up riding Suzuki dirt bikes, so, you know, I was familiar with the brand, and that's what I wanted. Well, the guy's like, hey man, you know, you tried out a Yamaha FZ07, let's sit on it, see, you know, just so you can get a feel for the different comfort. So I got off the SV and walked over and sat on the Yamaha. I'm familiar with the Yamaha, very familiar. And the seat height on it is about the same as the R6, maybe just a little shorter, not much. Saddle is a little slimmer, but again, not by much. It's very, very close to the feel of that bike. So he asked me if I had seen this Kawasaki. I said no. And he took me over to it, and I sat on it, and as soon as I did, it was like I was in love with the bike. It just, the slimness, the way it meshes and feels, super comfortable for me as a short guy. Even more comfortable than the SV, which was blowing my mind, because when I sat on the SV, I was like, yes, this is me. I'm buying this bike today. This changed my mind. This is one of the most comfortable sport bikes I have ever sat on in my life. I had an old 500R, what I started out on back in the mid-90s, made Kawasaki, you know, the little ninjas. And it was a great bike, but it was even higher than this. Of course, they had this, you know, little banana-looking seats and everything. The ergonomics were not near what it is today on bikes. It's huge improvements that not only Kawasaki, but a lot of other bike manufacturers have made. But this bike and the slimness of the saddle and the tank reminds me a lot of the Italian bikes, Ducatis especially, which is another brand I was looking at, the 696 Monster and the older 620. You know, I wanted a sport, naked sport bike, I guess. And I'm glad I found this bike. I love it. I think it would be a very confidence-inspiring bike for new riders, especially if you want a sport bike. It's not so touchy where you get on the throttle and you're going to lose control of it. There is a lot of low-end torque and mid-range on this bike, and that's particularly why I love it. If you're stuck in traffic, you just barely turn the throttle and she goes. That bike, if you're in the lower RPM range, it's not as responsive, but it tacks up super fast, which could cause you to lose control of it. That is for an experienced rider. Short person, yeah, you can get on that bike and ride all day long like a champ, but you need to start with something that's more comfortable for you. The problem with, you'll hear a lot of people say, get a 250, get a 300. They're just as tall as these bikes. There's no difference. Or somebody will say, get the Z125 or the Grom. They still have a high seat height. Yes, they're very narrow, very slim, very lightweight. If you're going to use it for an around town commuter and all, yeah, you know, or you want to learn how to wheelie, if that's the path you want to take, that will be a perfect bike for you. But if you're wanting something you can hang with your friends or go on long road trips for, you're going to want a bigger bike, something with more fuel capacity, a little more power. You want to take it to the mountains. You've got to have that little bit of extra power and comfort. Comfort's going to be a big factor. Like I said, the only complaint about this one so far, it being brand new, is the seat's not softened up yet. No modifications suspension-wise to either bike. I handle either one just fine. If you have any questions or comments, feel free to ask. I reply to almost every comment that's posted on my channel. I try my very best to keep in touch with the people that view and subscribe. Don't let people that are not of the same stature, being short, you'll hear a lot of bad advice from tall people telling you need to do something one way or the other, when they have no clue. Unless they were doing it when they were 10 years old and when they were our height, just tell them to, you know, shut the F up and send them to my channel. I'm a short guy that's been riding probably longer than most of these guys have been alive. So, with that being said, stay safe on the road, do your research, and I'll see you next time.